Linux Mint Cinnamon vs. Ubuntu Cinnamon. Canonical has incorporated a version with the sole absent desktop environment among its official derivatives. This comparison delves into features, performance, and fundamental distinctions between Linux Mint Cinnamon and Ubuntu Cinnamon. Until spring 2023, Canonical, the company behind Ubuntu, released versions of Ubuntu with various desktop environments found in the Linux world, except for Cinnamon. Cinnamon is a simple, traditional, and elegant desktop environment originally created for Linux Mint, based on GNOME 3. With the release of Ubuntu 23.04, Canonical has officially recognized Cinnamon as an independent project and elevated it to the status of an official flavor. I was curious to try Ubuntu Cinnamon and took the opportunity to compare it with the LTS version of Ubuntu and Linux Mint Cinnamon, which is only released in LTS versions. I browse websites to obtain the corresponding ISO images for creating live media, facilitating the testing and installation of various systems. However, official derivatives based on Ubuntu LTS often have limited support and updates, typically spanning 3 years. The Linux Mint website underwent a significant transformation with the introduction of Mint 21. Notably, Linux Mint utilizes the package base of Ubuntu 22.04 LTS, offering an extended support period of 5 years from the release date. The ISO file for Ubuntu Cinnamon has a size of 5.1 GB, while the Linux Mint Cinnamon ISO file is 3 GB in size, excluding any additional data. Linux Mint Cinnamon comes with the default 5.15 kernel, the same one used in Ubuntu. However, you can easily update to newer kernels, like 5.19 or 6.2, with just one click in the Update Manager. If you're facing issues with hardware installation, it's recommended to install the Edge version, which runs directly on kernel 6.2. For Ubuntu Cinnamon, the initial ISO uses the 5.19 kernel. But during updates, you'll notice that it installs and applies the 6.2 kernel. Regarding the types of Cinnamon being used, Ubuntu Cinnamon uses version 5.2.4, while Linux Mint uses version 5.8.4. There's a roughly 2-year gap between these versions. Now, let's talk about what your computer needs. Finding the official information about what your computer needs to run Ubuntu is a bit tricky. The details are usually mentioned in magazines or blogs related to computers. I'm not sure if there are specific requirements for the Cinnamon edition, unlike the Mate edition, for example. Here are the things your computer should have for Ubuntu. A processor that runs at 2 GHz and has 2 cores. At least 4 GB of RAM. Make sure your computer has 25 GB of free space on its hard drive. The screen resolution should be at least 1024 by 768 pixels. For Linux Mint, when you choose which version to download, you can find information about what your computer needs in the release announcement on the blog. They always mention the minimum and recommended requirements. Here are the requirements for Linux Mint Cinnamon. Your computer should have at least 2 GB of RAM, but it's better to have 4 GB. Make sure there's at least 20 GB of free space on your hard drive, but it's better to have 100 GB. The screen resolution should be at least 1024 by 768 pixels. The Ubuntu installer is like a flagship tool called Ubiquiti. When you start the live session, you pick the language and decide whether to test the system or install it right away. The reason Ubuntu is successful is because it adds simplicity to the Debian base. The program OS Prober checks if there are boot partitions, helping you recognize pre-installed systems. You can then manually or automatically adjust partitions, resizing them easily with a drag and drop. Mint and other similar systems borrow significant code from Ubuntu, especially from Ubiquiti. Mint's installation program is a modified version of Ubuntu's, differing mainly in presentation slides. For a fair comparison, I chose not to download updates during the Ubuntu installation. Linux Mint doesn't offer this option. I included drivers and multimedia codecs, just like I do with Mint, and opted for a full installation since Mint doesn't provide a minimal installation. As I always suggest, install Linux with an active internet connection to make sure all translations not included for each language in the ISO are installed. For Linux Mint, it only took 4 minutes to install before you had to restart. When putting Ubuntu Cinnamon on your computer, it took about 10 minutes. It's important to note that the installation times for Ubuntu and its variations, even unofficial ones, are quite long. I was pleasantly surprised when I first tried Ubuntu Cinnamon. It combines the familiar look of Canonical distributions with the Cinnamon desktop and menu, all with the default dark theme. This customization is unique and something I hadn't seen outside of Linux Mint. In Ubuntu Cinnamon, they've successfully blended the Cinnamon desktop with the typical Ubuntu Jara themes. This creates a nice, cohesive look that I really like. Even other desktop environments like KDE, Lubuntu, and Xubuntu don't capture the essence of Ubuntu like this. When you launch Linux Mint Cinnamon, you'll see a welcome screen with helpful documentation and suggested steps for post-installation setup. Interestingly, this screen is not present in Ubuntu Cinnamon or other distros using Cinnamon. If you're familiar with Linux Mint, you'll notice a change in the default color when you first launch it. The usual green has been replaced with a mix of yellow and light blue, based on user preferences. Regardless of the distribution, the startup times for both Ubuntu Cinnamon and Linux Mint in a single boot are similar, taking around a dozen seconds. Shortly after starting Ubuntu Cinnamon for the first time, it notified me about 352 megabytes of updates. It took an extra 5 minutes to install them, then asked for a restart. However, this wasn't the end, as the software application prompted me to download another 257 megabytes of updates, making a total of almost 600 megabytes added to the initial 5 gigabytes ISO. In Linux Mint, a red dot in the applet bar signals available updates, and the welcome screen suggests updating first. The update manager, different from Ubuntu, providing information and encouraging users to modify repository sources for faster updates. The total update size is 721 megabytes, and Linux Mint comes with only open source drivers pre-installed. The welcome screen suggests checking for drivers, leaving it to the user to decide on proprietary ones. Unlike Ubuntu Cinnamon, which automatically set the NVIDIA driver on the first boot, Linux Mint gives users the choice to apply proprietary drivers. After finishing the updates for both operating systems, I restart the computer. When I check, Ubuntu Cinnamon uses about 1.17 gigabytes of memory when it's not doing anything. The updated version of Linux Mint Cinnamon uses around 839 megabytes of RAM. I'm looking through the Ubuntu menu, and as someone who's used to Linux Mint Cinnamon, I see some programs that are not usually in my system. For example, there's DejaDup for backup, GTK Hash for checking ISO file signatures, and TextInfo Viewer in the accessories. In the sound and video section, there's Celluloid for videos and Rhythmbox for listening to music and organizing libraries. Ubuntu Cinnamon also has a games category with some pre-installed programs. In the graphics section, there's GNOME Photos, GIMP, GThumb, and Shotwell for organizing photos. For internet stuff, there's Thunderbird and Firefox, along with Remina for remote desktop and transmission for torrents. In the Office section, there's GNOME Calendar and LibreOffice. When it comes to administration, Ubuntu and Mint have some differences. Ubuntu has the Snap Store and Software Center for Deb packages, while Mint has the Software Manager based on the Ubuntu, supporting Debs, Mint packages, and the latest apps in Flatpak. Ubuntu Cinnamon also supports traditional HTOP along with the GNOME System Monitor, which is the default task manager for Linux Mint. But there are many similarities, like photo and document viewers, disk analysis tools, media formatting, text editor, Synaptic, calculator, compressed archive manager, and more. Let's talk about Linux Mint. In the accessories section, there are some additional programs compared to Ubuntu. These include Notes, which is like a digital notepad, Redshift that reduces the blue light in the evening, Bulky, also known as File Renamer, for renaming files in a series, Onboard for an on-screen keyboard, and Warpinator, a Mint team-created program for easy file sharing on a local network. In the sound and video section, besides Celluloid and Rhythmbox, there's Hypnotix, a Mint-exclusive program for watching TV from around the world online. In the graphics section, Pix, a revamped program based on GThumb, is used instead of GThumb or Shotwell. Some time ago, GIMP was replaced by Drawing, a simpler program for basic drawing and photo editing, complementing the editing options in Pix. The internet section includes Thunderbird and Firefox, and there's web apps for managing frequently used websites as separate programs. HexChat is also there for connecting with support volunteers through Mint's IRC channel. Linux Mint stopped pre-installing games a while ago. In the Office section, besides LibreOffice, there's Library. It organizes text files, LibreOffice documents, PDFs, and recently opened ebooks while tracking reading progress. Linux Mint has Time Shift for creating system restore points, a useful feature for ensuring system reliability. In summary, Linux Mint has a slightly larger software selection compared to Ubuntu, excluding a few games and GIMP. The Mint installation file is over 2 GB smaller than Ubuntu Cinnamon, possibly due to the absence of bulkier snap packages found in Ubuntu. Users of both systems experience customized versions of the desktop environment, diverging from the majority of other distributions that adhere to the Udvata theme. Despite this, both systems provide access to the NeMo file manager, complemented by the option to seamlessly incorporate numerous extensions. Users encounter a variety of applets, desklets, and themes that can be easily integrated with a single click. Regrettably, I have confirmed that some desklets and applets, around 5 or 6 in number, which have been a staple in my Linux Mint experience for years, consistently cause Cinnamon to crash in Ubuntu. It is disheartening that users may form an inaccurate perception of Cinnamon based on issues attributed to the Ubuntu edition. I was talking about the main differences between two operating systems. The big distinctions are in how they manage and install software. For Ubuntu, there's the software application for Deb packages. These packages come from the unstable branch of Debian and are stabilized by Canonical. There's also the Snap Store, which has programs bundled with all the necessary dependencies to ensure smooth and conflict-free operation. Ubuntu doesn't include Flatpaks for competition reasons. On the other hand, Linux Mint seamlessly integrates Flatpaks into the software manager, making them easily recognizable. In Linux Mint, the Snap Store is not allowed. The Linux Mint team independently compiles Firefox and Chromium browsers from the source and provides them to users through their own repository, as these browsers are no longer available in the Ubuntu repositories. In essence, the similarities between the two operating systems primarily revolve around a shared foundation of software packages, encompassing system installation, the Software Center for Deb packages, and the management of certain services. Additionally, both systems adopt the same desktop environment, albeit in different versions, resulting in a similar appearance despite customizations by their respective development teams. To put it succinctly, Ubuntu and Linux Mint reciprocally draw inspiration and features from each other, showcasing the inherent nature of open-source collaboration. A crucial commonality lies in the substantial size and generosity of their user communities, extending support even to Linux newcomers. While Ubuntu boasts a vast following, it's important to note that Linux Mint's international user base is not proportionally smaller. Both distros share a familiarity with documentation, tutorials, and responsive support in official forums. The distinctions emerge when considering their origins and financial backing. Ubuntu stems from Canonical, a for-profit company with a substantial 2020 turnover of $138 million. This financial strength empowers Ubuntu to sustain an open-source project with the expectation of financial returns. In contrast, Linux Mint originated from a programmer's initiative who, with the support of a few dozen programmers, relies on sponsors, donations, and agreements with Mozilla for integration purposes. It's crucial to emphasize that a significant differentiator between the two distros is the absence of the Snap Store in Linux Mint and the Flathub Store in Ubuntu. Furthermore, Linux Mint offers 2 additional years of support compared to any other official Ubuntu derivative. Determining the best choice among Linux distributions is subjective and dependent on personal preferences, needs, and liking. In my case, after testing Ubuntu Cinnamon, it didn't persuade me to switch from my preferred operating system, Linux Mint Cinnamon. Despite its stylized and customized interface, Cinnamon in Ubuntu lacks seamless integration with its typical components like applets, desklets, and extensions. Unlike Linux Mint, where these elements work flawlessly, some adjustments are needed to enhance the desktop experience on Ubuntu Cinnamon. One notable preference I have is for distributions that don't adopt Snap. It's disappointing to find Firefox available only in Snap format. Additionally, encountering issues during the initial Ubuntu installation raised concerns. The integration of Cinnamon into Ubuntu seems less refined compared to its integration in Linux Mint. Another point of consideration is the automatic application of proprietary video drivers, which users should be warned about. Moreover, the size of the ISO image is comparable to that of Windows, and Ubuntu installations, even in a virtual machine, typically take longer than Linux Mint. Canonical's move to introduce a Cinnamon edition is appreciated. This could be seen as recognition of the Mint team's work and the influence of Ubuntu Remix. The Cinnamon edition aligns with the main GNOME-based edition while reflecting the distinctive nature of Ubuntu. The Ubuntu Cinnamon edition might attract new Linux users transitioning from Windows, especially those who find the GNOME environment disorienting. It could also appeal to users of other official Ubuntu flavors, such as Budgie. However, I don't believe this project will draw users away from Linux Mint. If I were to wager, I'd bet the opposite. Users of Ubuntu Cinnamon might explore Linux Mint out of curiosity, seeking to experience Cinnamon in its birthplace with its optimal performance, or to appreciate the different philosophy and avoid Snap integration. In summary, it is essential to acknowledge that Canonical has significantly propelled the growth and widespread adoption of Linux in the desktop sector. Noteworthy distributions like Linux Mint, Elementary OS, Zorin OS, Pop OS, and numerous others have thrived as a result. The primary beneficiaries are the end users who have discovered robust alternatives to operating systems that once bound them to usage monitoring, specific software and formats, or unnecessary hardware changes when their existing systems were still perfectly functional. Therefore, our gratitude extends to Linux and the broader realm of open source for the positive impact it has had, including the introduction of Ubuntu Cinnamon as a refreshing addition to the landscape. Which distribution do you prefer, Linux Mint Cinnamon or Ubuntu Cinnamon? Share your thoughts in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more content.